2 plus 2 makes 5 is the paradigmatic example of an obvious falsehood, a falsehood that everybody knows to be false, because 2 plus 2 is equal to 1, right? At the end of this video, you'll know what I'm talking about. George Orwell famously used 2 plus 2 equals 5 in his novel 1984 as an example for an obviously false statement that you can nevertheless make people believe in. The same example was used already in 1789 by the French priest and writer Emmanuel Sieyès in his essay What is the Third Estate? At this time, the Third Estate, the bourgeoisie, made up the big bulk of the population in France, but wasn't allowed to vote. Sieyès wrote, "If it be claimed that under the French Constitution, 200,000 individuals out of 26 million citizens constitute two-thirds of the common will, only one comment is possible. It is a claim that 2 and 2 make 5. This was briefly before the French Revolution. So you can see there's a heavy legacy to using 2 plus 2 is 5 as an example of an obvious untruth. And if you claim otherwise, that can understandably upset some people. For example, the mathematician Karim Khar recently got fire on Twitter for pointing out that 2 plus 2 isn't always equal 4. He was accused of being woke because he supposedly excused obviously wrong math as okay. Even he was surprised at how upset some people got about it, because his point is of course entirely correct. 2 plus 2 isn't always equal to 4. And I don't just mean that you could change the symbol 4 with the symbol 5. You can do that, of course, but that's not the point. The point is that 2 plus 2 is a symbolic representation for the properties of elements of a group. And the result depends on what the 2's refer to and how the mathematical operation plus is defined. Strictly speaking, without those definitions, 2 plus 2 can be pretty much anything. That's where the joke comes from that you shouldn't let mathematicians sort out the restaurant bill, because they haven't yet agreed on how to define addition. To see why it's important to know what you are adding and how, let's back up for a moment to see where the normal addition law comes from. If I have 2 apples and I add 2 apples, then that makes 4 apples, right? Right. Okay, but how about this? If I have a glass of water with a temperature of 20 degrees and I pour it together with another glass of water at 20 degrees, then together the water will have a temperature of 40 degrees. No, certainly not. If both glasses contained the same amount of water, the final temperature will be 1/2 the sum of the temperatures, so that'd still be 20 degrees, which makes much more sense. Temperatures don't add by the rule 2 plus 2 equals 4. And why is that? It's because temperature is a measure for the average energy of particles, and averages don't add the same way as apples. The average height of women in the United States is 5 feet 4 inches, and that of men 5 feet 9 inches. But that doesn't mean that the average American has a height of 11 feet 1. You have to know what you're adding to know how to add it. Another example. Suppose I switch on a flashlight. The light moves at, well, the speed of light. And as you know, the speed of light is the same for all observers. We learned that from Albert Einstein. Yes, that guy again. Now, suppose I switch on the flashlight while you come running at me at, say, 10 kilometers per hour. At what velocity is the light coming at you? Well, that's the speed of light plus 10 kilometers per hour, right? No, because that'd be faster than the speed of light. What is going on? What's going on is that velocities don't add like apples either. They merely approximately do this if all the velocities involved are much smaller than the speed of light. But strictly speaking, they have to be added using this formula. Here, U and V are the 2 velocities that you want to add, and W is the result. C is the speed of light. You see, immediately, if one of the velocities, say u, is also the speed of light, then the resulting velocity stays the speed of light. So if you add something to the speed of light doesn't change. If you come running at me, the light from my flashlight still comes at you with the speed of light. Indeed, if you add the speed of light to the speed of light, because maybe you want to know the velocity at which two light beams approach each other head-on, you get c plus c equals c. So in units of the speed of light, according to Einstein, 1 plus 1 is 1. That's some examples from physics for quantities that just have different addition laws. Here's another one from mathematics. Suppose you want to add two numbers that are elements of a finite group. To keep things simple, say a group with only three elements. We can give these elements the numbers 0, 1, and 2. We can then define an addition rule on this group, which I'll write as a plus with a circle around it to make clear it's not the usual addition. This new addition rule works like this. Take the usual sum of two numbers, then divide the result by 3 and take the rest. So, for example, 1 plus 2 equals 3, divide by 3, the rest is 0. The addition is defined so that we stay within the group. And by this addition law, we have 1 plus 2 equals 0, and by the same rule, 2 plus 2 equals 1. I know this looks odd, but it's completely standard mathematics, and it's not even very advanced mathematics. It just isn't commonly taught in school. This remainder after division is usually called the modulus. So this addition law can be written as the plus with the circle equals the normal plus mod 3. A set of numbers with this addition law is called a cyclic group. You can't only do this with 3, but with any integer number. For example, if you take the number 12, that just means if you add numbers to something larger than 12, you start over from 0 again. That's how clocks work, basically. 8 plus 7 equals 3, add another 12, and that gives 3 again. We're fairly used to this. Clocks are a nice visual example for how to add numbers in a cyclic group, but timekeeping itself is not an example for cyclic addition. That's because the real physical time, of course, does not go in a circle. It's just that on a simple clock, we might not have an indicator for the time switching from AM to PM or from one day to the next. So in summary, if you add numbers, you need to know what it is that you're adding and take the right addition law to describe what you're interested in. If you take two integers and use the standard addition law, then yes, 2 plus 2 equals 4. But there are many other things those numbers could stand for and many other addition laws, and depending on your definition, 2 plus 2 might be 2 or 1 or 5 or really anything at all. That's not woke, that's math. This video was sponsored by Brilliant, which is a website and app that offers a large variety of courses on science and mathematics. The math that we learn at school is really just a tiny part of all known mathematics. And if you want to get an idea what else there is in the world of mathematics, Brilliant is a great starting point. Their courses are interactive, so you'll be challenged with questions along the way, which allows you to check your understanding. If you like this video, you may, for example, want to have a look at their courses on number theory, logic, or algebra. You can also check out their Mathematical Fundamentals course, which is a mix of those three topics. To support this channel and learn more about Brilliant, go to brilliant.org/Sabine and sign up for free. The first 200 subscribers using this link will get 20% off the annual premium subscription. Thanks for watching. See you next week.